Yes, Ankit,
Yes, I'm here. I hope I'm audible to everyone.
Yes, guys, can you hear Ankit? Ankit, can you speak something for all our attendees here?
Hello, people. It will be very nice of you if you can acknowledge the fact that you can hear my voice.
Okay, yes, they are acknowledging the fact that they can hear your voice. Okay, guys, welcome to the guest seminar today. It's a very, very special day, and we have Mr. Ankit Dubey along with us. Honestly, there are very few people whom I admire very much, and one of them is Ankit. He has aced this admit season, the fall 2015 admit season, with 7 admits and 1 full funding. Can you believe that? Right now people are congratulating you, Ankit. Yes, this is an amazing feat, and we shall be knowing as to how exactly Ankit was able to achieve all of this, and we shall also be answering all your questions, okay? So you need not worry about anything. We shall be making sure that all your questions are answered, okay? So, Ankit.
Yes, Ruchiraj, tell me.
Yes, so we shall be starting right now, okay? So, the
Yep.
agenda for today is this, okay? I hope that you guys are seeing this on the screen, the agenda for today. We shall be starting with an introduction, okay? Following which we shall be discussing about the profile and admits that Ankit has got, his mode of preparation for GRE, the application procedure that he followed, and after that, finally, we shall be having a question and answer session specifically for all the questions that you guys have, and we'll make sure that all the questions are answered, and Ankit is also very, very excited to answer all your questions, aren't you, Ankit?
Yes, I'm looking forward to guide the young students. I hope I can be of some help.
Yes, absolutely. Okay, so can we start, Ankit?
Yeah, sure, let's go ahead.
Yes. Guys, now talking about Ankit, he is. Let's hear from Ankit. So, Ankit, could you please tell us something about yourself, as in your school? Where did you do your schooling from?
I was born and brought up in Roorkee. My father was a professor in IIT Roorkee. So I've been basically born and bred here. I did my schooling from here. After my schooling, I went to NIT Kurukshetra for my BTech in civil engineering. And after that, I worked for 2 years at WSP. It's a multinational British firm. And I quit my job after that to pursue a higher degree. After appearing for my GRE and GATE examination, I went to IIT Bombay to work as a project research assistant. I was there till last month, and now I'm here with you guys.
Okay, that's brilliant. Guys, talking about Ankit, last year he was with us. He was studying with GRE Edge. He was preparing for his GRE exam with GRE Edge. And last year, he had attended one such online guest seminar, in which we had invited Miss Harnoor Kaur. She also had full funding for PhD.
Yes.
And today, Mr. Ankit Dubey is with us. So, Ankit, what is the feeling like?
I'm really happy that all my hard work has paid off. It is very satisfying, to be very honest, and I'm very glad that today I'm in a position that I can share my experiences to the other students who are aspiring for higher education now. So I hope I can be of some help.
Absolutely, absolutely, Ankit. We are also looking forward to your inputs. Okay, so Ankit, where did you do your undergraduation from?
I did my undergrad from NIT Kurukshetra.
NIT Kurukshetra. In which branch?
Civil engineering.
Civil engineering. Okay. So, Ankit, could you please tell me one fond memory that you have of your undergraduation? The 4 years of undergraduation, that one thing that you would not be forget, or you would not be able to forget for the rest of your life.
To be honest, I think college, everyone would agree here that college is the best time of everyone's life. So it will be very hard to pinpoint one exact moment which I can be very fond of. But yes, I remember my convocation. It was a very memorable moment. and because we met all of our friends after a very long time, and that moment stayed with me for a long time. Apart from that, I remember making lifelong friends who have stuck by me through thick and thin.
Okay, that's great. Well, it's obvious that anybody who is studying in an engineering college right now or is also graduated, their fond memories and every moment that they have spent with their friends over the past period of over the 4 years that they have spent in a particular college, well, those days would have been the best days of their lives. What do you say, guys?
Yes, exactly. Exactly.
So yeah, most of them admit that the best time that they have had is in their college. Well, Ankit, so would you like to share some memories of yours, as in things that you did while you were working for the company that you mentioned about?
I remember that our projects were basically based in the Middle East, and we were given instructions to carry out design in Noida. So I remember that I really learned about people skills during my job. I learned that I need to weigh my words correctly, because in college you are very brash, you can be very honest with everyone, but at workplace you can't be openly honest to anyone, you can't afford to offend anyone. So basically I learned to weigh my words correctly, I learned how to be around people, I learned to basically work under the pressure of a tight deadline. So I'm thankful for my experience, because it has taught me a lot.
Okay. Well, so would you like to share some experience of yours in terms of the research that you did in IIT Bombay?
In a nutshell, if you can say that my PhD is the movie, then my project in IIT Bombay was a trailer to that.
Okay.
I was introduced to the methodology of research, I was given a problem and I didn't have any background knowledge about that, so I scoured the literature, I worked on the problem, and I came to a solution. So that was basically a precursor to my graduate school life.
Okay. Well, moving on. Now, I'm sure that most of you would like to know something that plays a very important decision in Ankit's life. That is, when did he realize that he should quit his job and pursue master's? So, Ankit, would you like to answer that question?
In a job, initially there's always a 3 or 4 months honeymoon period where you get your first salary, you have all the parties, you go to all the pubs and enjoy yourself. But after that, after 1.5 years, I realized that I could have stayed in the job and, you know, grown, but I wanted to expand my skills. I wanted to face new challenges. I wanted to face more technically more advanced problems, and basically I wanted to better myself as a person. And that is when I realized that I need to quit my job and go for a higher degree.
Okay, so basically I'm hoping that all the attendees over here are making a note of whatever Ankit is saying. Well, it's quite interesting to know that while you had a very good job, you still wanted to pursue your master's, and that's something that we should also always do, because I would really appreciate the fact that you are getting into what you love to do. So that's something that inspires a lot of people, and I'm sure. Well, over here, Bhargav asks, where is Ankit right now? Well, Ankit, would you like to answer Bhargav?
I'm at my hometown. I'm waiting. I'm counting the days till I fly to USA.
Okay. Well, Bhargav, Ankit is in Roorkee. That's his hometown. Ankit, you were saying.
I was saying that it really depends on person to person, because I've seen many batchmates of mine who are very happy in their jobs. But ultimately, my aim was that I wanted to experience more new things and more technically advanced things. So that's why I quit my job. It really depends on the person.
Great. Well, guys, can you guys hear us properly? Is there any glitch in terms of the sound or anything? Well, perfect. Well, Ankit, the next question from my side is, what was your motivation for doing your master's?
Mm-hmm. See, I'm a civil engineer, and in civil engineering, you need to have a specialization. Like, I don't want to go into the technical details, but like if I want to be a good structural engineer, I need to have a master's degree in structures. So that was my main motivation, that I wanted a specialization so that I can work on focus areas, and that's how I could be exposed to better profiles, because undergraduates, they can grow by experience, but if you get a higher degree and come back to the company, you'll be in a better position. So that was one of my motivation to pursue masters.
Okay, that's brilliant. Well, over here, I would like to take one question that is being posted by Homagni Shah Saha.
Yeah.
Well, she asks, how did you get the IIT Bombay internship?
I think we can focus on it after the seminar, because that will be disrupting the flow of it. But
absolutely,
I can
absolutely.
Like get the yes. Are you fine with it? We can note it down
yeah.
and we can
no issues,
answer,
no issues,
answer it
absolutely.
Later.
You're correct. Well, let's move on. I hope Homagni is fine with it.
I hope Homagni is not offended.
well, yes. So moving on, my next question to you, Ankit, is why did you choose the United States for doing your masters? Why not any other country?
To be honest, it's a very easy choice. United States has the best educational infrastructure in the world, and most importantly, their rules and regulations towards immigrants and new students are very friendly. If you can check the latest news, which I hope many GRE aspirants do, you can check it out that UK is very stringent towards foreign students, but USA is very welcoming. They encourage you to apply there, and they give you quite a lot of freedom in terms of work visas as well. So USA is definitely the destination if you want to go for higher studies.
Okay. Well, now we come down to the most interesting part, and something that has not only made Ankit's parents proud, but a lot of us proud, and I'm sure that a lot of people admire you for the fact that you have got 7 admits. Well, can we have a huge round of applause? Well, Ankit, now could you please tell us from which all universities did you get your admits from?
I got my, I think the most prestigious admit would be Stanford University, then Cornell, Purdue University, University of Southern California, North Carolina State University, University of California at Los Angeles, and University of California at San Diego. These 7 things.
Well, that's brilliant. Well, let me repeat the number of universities, as in universities that Ankit got an admit from: Stanford University, Purdue, University of California in Los Angeles, Cornell, North Carolina State University, University of California, San Diego, and University of South Carolina. Well, that's a brilliant feat, Ankit, and I'm sure that this is something that a lot of students who are attending the seminar would aspire to get. So, well, Ankit, Ankit, now coming down to the choice that you have made, okay? Now, which university did you finally choose?
I'm finally, it might surprise a few people, but I'm finally going to North Carolina State University for my PhD.
Well, that's a brilliant choice, Ankit, and I'm sure a lot of students, for a lot of students, that would probably be a dream university, isn't it, guys? Well, yes. Let's move on. Well, Ankit, now the question comes here. Why did you choose NCSU?
To be honest, I spent quite a few sleepless nights over the decision. But I can narrow it down to 3 reasons. First of all, is that I got a fully funded PhD offer. All of my expenses are covered. I'll be earning while I'm learning, so that is a good thing. Rest of the offers were for unfunded MS. But I should make a point here that students should not be an unfunded MS offer, because usually people go there, explore their options, and get some funding. Coming back to my point, I'll be working in a research group that is the only university-based research group of its kind. It's a very special research group, and basically they are pioneers in their respective fields. And thirdly, I talked to all the graduates of the research group there, and they encouraged me to come there, and they said that if I chose NCSU, I won't regret the decision. So after all these decisions, reasons basically, I finally chose NCSU. Hello.
Okay, well, I'm sure a lot of students are waiting out here to ask you a lot of questions, isn't it, guys? Well, I would request you to kindly be patient. In the end, we would be having a completely different segment in which we shall be discussing about the questions that you guys would be putting up to Ankit and me, and we shall be answering all of them. And I'm sure Ankit is also eagerly waiting to answer you guys. Well, Atin says good choice, brother. Okay, and Suleiman says thank you.
Thanks,
well,
Atin.
Suleiman, you're most welcome. And a lot of good feedback is coming up for you, Ankit. So how do you feel about it?
I feel happy. At least people are not cursing me for leaving Stanford.
Well, that's something of a great choice. Well, you had a list of brilliant universities, and the reason which you have told to us will pretty much justifies your choice, isn't it, guys? Gaurav says yes. Nishwari says yes. Akshay also affirms. Everybody says yes. Vipin, Anup, Amit, Anubhav, Niveda, Nagarjuna, everybody says you have done a good thing by getting into a university that you feel deemed to be, which you choose, and you have good opportunities for research, and everything that you have said pretty much justifies the fact that you have made a brilliant choice. Well, moving on. Now the next
thanks,
question
guys.
To you.
Thanks for your words. It means a lot.
Yes. Well, moving on. So, Ankit, which stream do you be specializing in?
Yep.
Hello. Ankit.
Yeah. Can you hear me?
Yes. Yes, Ankit, we can hear you. So, which stream do you be specializing
in?
Yeah, I'm
here. Yeah. I'll be specializing in structural engineering and mechanics.
You'll be specializing in structural engineering and mechanics. Okay, so over here, I would like to take up one question that has been posted by Sumant Yanamala. Well, the question is, all
yes,
engineers
sure.
choose computers for masters. You choose the civil engineering. Do you think that you can earn money that you're spending on your masters? Well, Sumant, I would like to tell you something. He has got a fully funded PhD. Okay, so I believe it pretty much justifies the fact that he is looking forward to an exciting career in front of him. Isn't it, Ankit?
But Richard, I think we can take this question in a sense. I think he says that other fields are not that well paid. I think he wants to answer it like that. Can you
yes.
read the whole question for me, please?
Yes. Well, he asks, all engineers choose computers for masters.
Mm-hmm.
You chose the civil engineering.
Mm-hmm.
You think that you can earn the money
mm-hmm.
that you're spending on masters? Top prospective of civil engineers in USA. Excited to listen from you, Ankit, as he's also a civil engineer. Well, yes. Now, I would like you to answer, Ankit.
As a civil engineer, I think you should look beyond these things. It is very important to have a very broad perspective and look beyond your pay packages. You guys are still bachelors, in doing your bachelors, and it's very important that you fall in love with the subjects which you're studying, because pay packages ultimately even out. To be honest, there's a slight difference in the starting. Computer guys might be earning a little more than you, but you'll be doing this structural engineering or civil engineering for your whole life. You can't compensate that with a few $1,000. So guys, please broaden your perspective a little. I'd like to keep my foot down and say that. And please look beyond the pay packages.
Okay. Well, that's a brilliant answer. Thanks for the answer, Ankit. Well, can we move on with the discussion, guys? I request you to please keep your questions for a while. We have a Q&A session in the end of the seminar. I request you guys to kindly be patient for a while. And I assure you that by the end of the seminar, we will answer all your questions. Isn't it, Ankit?
Yeah, sure. That's what we're here for.
Yes, absolutely. Well, now my next question to you, Ankit, is why did you choose civil structural engineering?
The decision was made basically. I was introduced to the courses of structural analysis and design of steel structures and design of concrete structures, and I was lucky enough to have good professors, and I really got interested in to what I was learning, and that's it. The decision was made then and there only.
Okay. Well, a lot of questions are again being asked. Well, guys, your questions are pretty relevant, I'm sure. Well, as we move on with this seminar, I'm sure a lot of questions of yours would get answered. A lot of questions are coming up, Ankit. Well, a lot of people are very eager for you to answer their questions. Well, let's get done with this with a set of questions that we have already.
Yeah, sure.
We shall start with the Q&A session as soon as possible. Okay. So, Ankit, why PhD?
The most exciting part about a PhD is that after graduating, we'll have the gates of both academia and industry open to me. I can either become a professor or I can go into the industry as a senior researcher. Plus, a PhD is the highest academic degree one can attain. So, holding a PhD means you always attract some kind of respect. So, that was the reason for my PhD decision.
Okay, well, that's a good answer, Ankit. Well, now I have yet another question. What exactly are you planning to do once you're done with your PhD?
Yeah. As I said that I've kept my mind open. I can either go into the industry or become a professor. To be honest, I'll decide during the course of the PhD that what aspect of my personality is suited to industry or a teaching job. So I'll decide during the course of the PhD. To be honest, I've not pinpointed or made a specific choice till now.
Okay. Well, Ankit,
yeah.
Now we would be taking up a couple of questions, okay? So, would you like to answer them?
Go ahead.
Yes. So, well, Ankit, there are a lot of questions here. So, let me choose a couple of questions here, which I can probably ask you.
Yeah. Sure.
Well, Bhargav here asks, do you think IIT Bombay project helped you in getting your funding?
No, it did not, because till then I had completed my application process. The IIT project happened after my application process. So, no, it did not.
Okay. Well, there's yet another guy who asks, any paper presentation you have done regarding structural engineering?
No, it's a myth that you need a paper presentation to get a PhD admit. I've seen people without paper presentations getting admits, but you need to have a very solid profile. You need to have a strong CGPA, you need to have very strong recommendations, and you need to have good internship experiences. Basically, if you don't have papers, you should have internships. If you don't have either papers and you don't have internships and you don't have a good CGPA, then I'm sorry, it will be a little tough for you. So you need to have some sort of relevant work experience on your resume.
Absolutely. Well, I'm hoping that the students over here who are attending the seminar are making notes of whatever Ankit is sharing with you guys, that anything that is relevant to your field of specialization, it could be a project or an internship or papers or research work, you have to do something or the other in order to increase the credibility of your profile. Isn't it, Ankit?
Exactly. It's a process. Basically, it begins right from your second year, right from the time you are studying your subjects. So you should, I think the target audience here is much older than that, but you should be conscious of the fact that you are building a profile towards something.
Okay, well, good. Now, there's yet another question that has been asked by Manoj Jana Yedulapalli. Well, the question is, can we apply to PhD without MS?
Yes, you can. You can have this. This is where the homework comes in. You need to go to the university's website, and universities which do not encourage direct PhDs have specified 100%. Like UCLA, I have seen that while applying, they have mentioned that they don't encourage students who don't have masters to apply for PhD. But if you go to the website of North Carolina State University, they specifically say that you can apply for a PhD and you can get in. So you have to do your homework here and be very meticulous about it.
Absolutely. Well, we'll be taking up one last question before we proceed with the seminar. Well, the question here is, Asta Sharma asks you, as you got so many admits, so apart from GRE score, what other things made this possible?
I had a relevant internship, international internship. I interned in Petrofac International Limited, Sharjah, United Arab Emirates for around 6 weeks after my third year. So international internships count. My CGPA was very solid. I was a gold medalist for the best major project. So these things counted. And my gold medal was for a project in structural engineering only. And my internship was in structural engineering only. So I think people will notice a trend here that everything was inclined towards structural engineering. And when you will write your statement of purpose, all of this will come into the picture.
Okay, well, last question, Ankit. Last question, okay? Well, Atre Ghosh asks, how much is a good CGPA? Should it be as high as 9.5?
I think a good CGPA is anything above 8.5. Yes.
Okay, well, now
Nine
we
point
shall.
five is is a 9.5 is a very high number. Only a few people in the department get it. So to be honest, if you get more than 8.5, it is very respectable.
Absolutely, absolutely, Ankit. Well, a lot of questions are coming up, and these are very relevant questions. I personally would like to ask you the questions, and there are a couple of questions that I would like to answer them personally, but then we need to finish the seminar, and then only we can proceed with the Q&A session, guys. So I request you to please be patient for a while, and I assure you that by the end of the seminar, we will answer all your questions. Please be a little more patient. Okay? So,
Yeah,
Ankit,
we are here. We are here. We'll answer all the questions.
absolutely. So, Ankit, we have a surprise for you. Are you ready?
Yeah, I am.
Well, we have a rapid fire question answer round with you, Ankit. So,
Oh my God.
yes. Okay, so rules, there are rules and regulations that we strictly need to follow, okay? So all the questions that I ask you have to be only one word, no diplomatic answers. If I ask you a yes or a no, you have to say either yes or no. If I ask you true or false, then you have to say true or false. Okay, it has to be one word.
You're putting me in a spot of bother here.
Yes, you have to answer me as quickly as possible. Okay, and as
Okay.
you have to give me your answer in 3 seconds.
Fine, I'll try.
Okay, so are you ready?
Yeah, I am.
Okay,
Let's go. Let's do it.
are you guys ready? Would you like to listen to what Ankit has to say for the rapid fire round? Rohit says yes, Akshay says yes, Vinayak says yes, Arshdeep, everybody is very, very excited. So can we start?
Yeah, sure. Let's go ahead.
Yes. So Ankit, football or cricket?
Football.
Favorite author?
Rohinton Mistry.
Favorite book?
The Kite Runner.
Where would you prefer working, India or America? Fast, Ankit, fast. 3 seconds. Where would you prefer working? India or
America.
America?
United States of America.
United States of America. Okay, favorite section in GRE, verbal or quant?
Verbal.
Okay, which is your favorite GRE word?
Serendipity.
Most challenging quant topic.
More probability, of course.
Most challenging verbal topic.
Reading comprehension, without a doubt.
Priyanka Chopra or Anushka Sharma?
Well, Priyanka Chopra, sorry.
Okay. Rate your overall GRE experience on a scale of 1 to 5.
4.
Favorite quant topic?
Favorite quant topic, fractions and decimals.
Favorite part in verbal?
Reading comprehension. Most challenging, but still most favorite.
Okay, well, that's interesting. Your favorite SFA, your quant SFA or your verbal SFA? And please keep this in your mind that they are also listening to this seminar.
My verbal SFA.
Verbal SFA. Okay, I'll inform Miss Jamuna that you have chosen Mr. Kulandesu over her. Okay, so one regret of your life.
I have all the respect. I have all the respect.
No, no
sorry,
justifications
I have all
required. Required, Ankit. We are moving ahead with the rapid fire round. One regret of your life.
Okay. One regret of my life.
Yes.
I don't think I have any regrets, to be honest. Yeah.
Well, that's brilliant. One achievement that you cherish for the rest of your life.
I think this one only, getting into NCSU for on a fully funded scholarship.
Well,
That's a
that's
big achievement.
brilliant. That's brilliant. So with this, we come to the end of the rapid fire round. Can we have a huge round of applause for Ankit, please? Well, Ankit, it is pretty interesting that you have answered all of them in more than 3 seconds. However, I believe that most of you had a good time. Did you guys have a good time? Well, everybody says yes. Asta says yes. Gaurav says yes. People loved it. Swati, Bitupan, Rakesh,
Yeah,
Arshdeep,
they love.
Gokul, everybody say yes. Well, it has been a brilliant session. So now we would like to know more about Ankit. Well, apart from the academics part, Ankit, you said you love football. So who exactly do you love football? And who is your favorite football player?
My favorite football player is Wayne Rooney, and my favorite team is Manchester United. I've been a lifelong supporter.
You've been a lifelong supporter of Manchester United. Okay, over here, Vivek says
Yes.
he loves Messi, and Naman Kala says
Neymar.
GGMU. Well, I
Yes,
believe
glory, glory, Man
you have
United.
one friend over here. Akshay says Messi, Barca. Anubhav also says
Well,
me too, GGMU. People say okay. Venkatesh says Neymar. Bhargav says Neymar. A diverse set of supporters here. Kaka, Ronaldo. Well, it's interesting. Okay, well, Ankit, now we know that you are an avid reader. So would you like to tell us something about your reading habits?
Basically, I stumbled about reading because I used to go into my school libraries and pick up books. I started with Famous Five series. Then I used to read Hardy Boys, and then I went on to the Harry Potter series. I absolutely loved it. And then I started reading more mature novels like by Ayn Rand, Fountainhead, and Atlas Shrugged. I loved all the novels of Khalid Hosseini, Kaitana, A Thousand Spirits and Suns, The Mountains Echoed. I loved A Fine Balance by Rohinder Mistry. I love the writings of Jhumpa Lahiri. I love the books of Rhonda Byrne. So I think you can figure out that I can go on and on and on and on and still can't stop about
Well,
reading and books.
absolutely. So, Ankit, if there were three books that you would like to recommend to all the students who are attending this seminar, which would be the three books?
I'd like to recommend The Monk Who Sold His Ferrari by Robin Sharma. I would like to recommend The Kite Runner by Khalid Hosseini. And last of all, I'd like to recommend The Secret by Rhonda Byrne.
Okay, well, I hope that the students have taken a note of this, because these are pretty interesting novels, and I'm sure that most of you love Harry Potter, because personally, Harry Potter is my favorite. How many of you love Harry Potter here? Well, Akshay says yes, Mudita, Rushikesh, Venkateshwar says he reads only that. Himanshu Kumar Singh loves it. Lopamudra, Rakesh, Sundar Pandian, Apurva, Bhanu, everybody seems to love Harry Potter. Okay. Well, over
Interesting.
here, there are a couple of questions being asked in terms of the books that you read. Which do you prefer more, fiction or non-fiction? That's been asked by Vishnu Brahmandamam. Which do you prefer more, fiction or non-fiction?
I've come to like more fiction books. I've read very less amount of non-fiction, so I love non-fiction. Oh, sorry, fiction.
Okay, well, that's brilliant. Okay, Ankit, now before we move on to your GRE preparations, there's one last thing that you would that I would like to ask you. Who is the inspiration of your life?
To be honest, I've not pinpointed a particular person, but I know that there's a characteristic trait. I love an underdog story. I love a person who comes back after getting basically knocked down by life and comes back to achieve what no one thought that he would. So I basically love an underdog story. I love a guy who overcomes adversity and achieves what he sets out to do. So that is the most inspiring thing for me.
Okay, well, over here I would be taking up two questions. Okay, so
Yeah.
Ankit, Arshdeep asks, is reading your pastime?
It's reading my pastime.
Yes, as in your hobby or something.
It is. Of course, it's my hobby. Yeah.
Okay, well, Vishnu asks, do you think the fictional books have helped you with your GRE preparations?
I think so, yes, but you cannot like say that it's only because of the fictional books, because I have developed this habit right from my childhood, right from the time I was 8 or 10 years old. And to be honest, I didn't know when I was 8 years old that I would be giving GRE. So they did help me, but I never did it consciously.
Okay, well, there is one very good question that has been asked by Sundara Pandian here, and I would really want you to answer this. Have you ever felt depressed?
Yes, I have, a lot of times.
Okay. Well, how do what all
Yes.
things did you do to overcome your depression?
The thing is that books give you the strength to face life. That's why I have recommended The Monk Who Sold His Ferrari, The Secret, to you guys, because there will be times when you feel that nothing is working out for you, nothing is like going according to plan. But you need to stay positive. You need to know that every situation has a upturn side to it. It can be upturned into a good, in a good, into a good situation. Basically, you need to have very positive attitude towards life.
Okay, with this, as you've discussed about how fiction books and non-fictional books have helped you in GRE and what all things have made Ankit Dubey an individual that he is today, we shall be starting with what most of our students here are waiting for. That is, how exactly did Ankit Dubey prepare for his GRE exams? So, Ankit, would you like to tell us how exactly did you plan for your GRE exam?
See, you guys must be aware that there are two sections, obviously, verbal and quant. So I was not worried too much about verbal. I was concerned, but I was not worried too much about it. So basically, the first step which I did was take a diagnostic test from GREH.com. It helps you to identify the areas where your weaknesses lie, and you need to focus on those areas. So I took the diagnostic test. I marked out the areas which I needed to work hard upon. For my vocabulary part, I would like to recommend a word board by GREH. You need to like go through, not mug up, go through the meanings of around 30 to 40 words daily. I did it. Should we focus on section-wise part, or should I give a general description?
as you feel is important. It's up to you.
Okay. So I think to score well in GRE, you cannot ignore the reading comprehension part, because I think around 50% of the questions in Verbal are from reading comprehension. So what it was, I bookmarked all the suggested reading material, the Hindu editorials, the Economic Times, the Economist. I marked it on my web browser, and I made it a habit of reading at least 4 to 5 difficult articles per day. That means, like, I read novels, like, it is very easy reading. I can read Chetan Bhagat very easily. I can read a sports article very easily. But if you have to read an article on history or economics or arts, it requires concentration, and you need to figure out that what the author is trying to say, and that will only come by practice. So you need to read 4 to 5 difficult articles, and by difficult I mean not pertaining to your field, per day, and you need to figure out what the author is trying to say. And remember that if you want to do well in Verbal, you must fall in love with the English language, and if you're not confident in your English and vocabulary, make sure you start preparing at least 5 months before GRE. The beautiful part about this is that if you pursue your Verbal section very passionately, then you will hone your personality. You'll read about things which you never knew existed. You'll read about personalities who never knew you were there. So it'll basically unravel a part of your personality which you thought was never there. Coming to the quant side, quants is very basic. You need to completely revise the concepts and practice. Practice is the key in quants, because the bane of the quants is that most of the students make very silly mistakes. I made very silly mistakes in quants, so I can say that I'm not perfect and I scored below my expectations. So you must chalk out your silly mistakes in quants and revise all the concepts. So
okay.
That is a basic idea.
Well, over here I would like to take up a couple of questions. Well, Saroj asks here,
yeah.
How much did you score in your diagnostic test, and how many marks have you improved in your final GRE?
I scored 310 in my diagnostic, 310.
And you have improved, and you scored 321, which is 11 points. That's brilliant. Can we have a huge round of applause for Ankit here? Well, there's one more question which Anoop asks here. How difficult were the words in GRE word board? Did it take some time for you to go through it?
See, in this case, the SFAs come in. They suggest you lists which are according to the difficulty. So basically, if you follow their instructions, you will get words which are increasingly difficult. Like, they're not difficult at a time. So I suggest that you follow the instructions and read 30 to 40 words daily. They'll be of varying difficulty. Some will be very easy, some will be very tough. But yes, you need to follow your SFA's advice here.
Okay. Well, Ankit, I would like to ask you, when did you start preparing for GRE? As in, how many months prior to your exam day did you start preparing for? How many months prior did you start preparing for, and in which month exactly did you start preparing for your GRE exam?
June 2014. I started by June 2014, yes.
Okay. And what was your target score?
320 plus, anything above 320.
Okay. Well, that's a good score that you had in your mind. Well, moving on. Can you guys hear me? Okay. Can you guys hear Ankit as well?
Can you hear me?
Yes. Everybody says yes. Utkarsh, Bitupan, Vishnu, Vipin, everybody says yes. Okay. Well, now let's get into the details of how exactly did you plan for your exam in terms of your quant preparation and your verbal preparation. Okay. Are you guys ready to listen to how exactly Ankit prepared for his quant and verbal preparations? Well, okay. So, talking about quants, okay? Ankit, Would you please give us a very detailed description as to what exactly did you do and what exactly should a student be doing as far as quants is concerned?
You just need to follow step by step the modules given by GREs.com. They are self-sufficient in themselves. I have seen lots of students who scour for lots of materials from three or four different books. You don't need to do that. Just go through the modules step by step. There's a proper learning part and there's a proper application part. So you will first learn the concepts and then you'll apply those concepts to the real world to the problems. So I said,
Hello.
after you are done preparing with the quant, hello.
Yes, Ankit, please continue.
More boost is that the ETS official GRE book, it is the most accurate book for GRE. You don't need to look. The most important aspect is.
Ankit,
Yes.
I believe there is some technical glitch from your side, so I would request you to kindly repeat whatever you have said.
Okay. Should I start from the quant?
Yes, quants.
Yeah, I'll start again.
Yes.
Yeah, so I basically practice the modules given by GREs.com. They are systematic and stepwise modules. First of all, there's a proper theoretical part, and then you can apply the theory which you have learned to problems. Secondly, I'd like to suggest the ETS official guide book of GRE. It is a very very good book. It's the most accurate book for GRE. So you can materials are timed tests. That is very important. So you'll be covered. Last but not the least is making short notes in a separate notebook which contains all the formulas and all far as quant is concerned. So in a nutshell, GRE's modules and the ETS guide, that's it.
Okay, well, I believe a lot of students have taken down the points here. Well, let's proceed to verbal. Okay, well, Ankit, what exactly did you do for verbal and what is it that you would like to recommend to all our students here as what exactly should they do to score a brilliant score in verbal section in their GRE?
I think verbal is the most challenging section of the GRE. It's a beautiful section, and I think you need to make reading a habit. If you do not read, or if you are a lazy reader, or if you're an intermittent reader, you need to cancel that out of your life right now, and you need to start reading immediately. Without reading, you cannot do well in GRE. So, for reading comprehensions, as I said earlier, you need to create bookmarks on your web browser, which contains links to The Hindu, The Economist, Business Insider, basically very good standard news websites, and read daily around 4 to 5 difficult articles, difficult pertaining to the fields which you are not familiar with, like arts, like history, like economics. And you need to make sense of what the author is trying to say. Only with practice are you going to improve your reading comprehension skills. As far as the other aspect from the reading comprehension is concerned, that can be completed by having a good vocabulary. So you must be observing a trend here. If you read, you have a good vocabulary, and if you read, you have a good sense of reading comprehension. So reading is the key here. Make reading a habit, and yes, that's it. I think make reading a habit and practice questions from the website GREs.com and ETS official guide.
Okay, well, now moving on to the AWA section. Now, we would like to have your inputs as far as the AWA section is concerned, Ankit.
Basically, I started preparation for AWS 2 weeks before the seminar. for the GRE. I used to write essays and then I used to email it to my SFA. So you need to be very meticulous. You need to be proactive. By what I mean to say, that you need to feel that I need to score well in AWS, so I need to contact my SFAs and get in touch with them and ask them to rate it. So what I used to do was daily write one essay, and they daily write one issue essay and one argument essay, and I used to send it to Kulande SAU and he used to rate it for me. And that helped a lot, because if a person is rating your essays and is telling you how to improve them, I think that is a very good feedback. That is, I think this is the best part about GRES, that the AW preparation, you get good evaluations from your SFAs.
Okay, well, over here, I would like to take up a couple of questions from the students. Okay, so Ankit, would you like to answer them?
Yeah, sure.
Okay, so Ankit, over here, Samarth asks, when did you give your GRE exam?
4th August 2014.
Okay. After that, there is Gaurav Pratik who asks, how much score did you get in GREH full length mock tests?
I used to get around 315 to 323 or 324. 324 was the highest I scored. So yes, I can quantify a range that was between 315 to 325.
Okay. Utkarsh here asks, how much is touch typing necessary for AWA?
Sorry, how much is?
Touch typing necessary for AWA.
Touch typing as in, I do not understand the context.
Well, touch typing is the keyboard. I don't think this is something that is very, very important here. However, Rupanch asks he says, I'm planning for MS in fall 2016 if I do research internship in 8SEM. Rupanch, questions like these, we would be answering them over overall profile evaluation is something that we are looking forward to in the end of the seminar in the Q&A session. Okay, so kindly be patient, okay? And if there is something related to the preparation, then I would request you guys to please ask them, because we would like to answer them right away.
Yeah, guys, please ask questions relevant to preparation right now.
Okay, well, Sri Lakshmi asks here, what kind of essays are preferred to read in AWA?
What kind of
essays are preferred to read in AW, as in what kind of articles or what kind of things should we be reading to in order to prepare for the AWS section?
Read the editorials of standard newspapers like Hindu, New York Times, Business Insider and The Economist.
Well, okay, Venkateshwar here asks, how many words did you learn from the WordBot?
I think I completed the whole series.
Okay, well, that's correct, guys. Ankit Dubey actually completed all the words from the WordBot, and we got a feedback from his SFAs. Unfortunately, they could not make it today because they had some personal commitments made. They have passed on a message for you, Ankit. Well, guys, I would like to tell you, Ankit was very, very regular, was a very regular student, and he took up all the tests at the right time. And this is something that the SFAs have appreciated the most, and they lauded Ankit's effort, and they have said that all the admits and everything that Ankit has achieved till now is absolutely justified. Okay. Well, here Ramandeep asks you, how were you able to manage 3,000 words in a couple of months?
Because I wanted to do it. That's it. I was determined. If you're determined about it, you'll do it no matter how.
Okay. Well, Devang here asks, in quants, I scored 159, and I think so giving again might give me a boost. What is your views, Ankit?
I'd like to ask Devang, what was his verbal score?
Devang, what was your verbal score? Well, as we receive, he says, facing issues with verbal section, I have appeared once GRE scoring 301. And the score was really low in verbal, that is 142. I need to restart again, so where should I start? What is the feedback to that, Ankit?
Okay, I feel that if you feel that you, at the time of the examination you were not prepared fully, then only you should retake the GRE. If you think that you had given your best and you still scored T01, you should not consider retaking it, because if you had already prepared completely and you'll do it again, I'm betting that you won't get more than 305. And 301 and 305, it's does not matter at all. So you need to ask yourself that, were you fully prepared or not? And if you were fully prepared, then do not give it. If you were not satisfied with your preparations, then go ahead and give GRE again.
Well, that's a brilliant answer, Ankit. So Sandesh here asks, how should be my approach if I have to complete the study as soon as possible?
It depends on how much time you have. You need to be specific with the question.
Okay. Well, Hemant here asks, reading novels is necessary for improving vocabulary. Well, he says, oh yeah, exactly. It's a question. So reading novels is necessary for improving vocabulary because I'll get bored by reading the novels. Is there any other option?
Read the Times of India, read newspapers, read anything you can get your hands on. It's pretty simple. Read sports articles. Just go on the website and start reading. Pick up, go to the Hindu website, go to the Times of India website. You can't do well in graduate school, in GRE, in your master's without having a good reading habit. So make it a habit.
Okay, Gautam here asks, could you kindly repeat the editorials for AWS section?
Editorials, okay. The Hindu, The Economist, The Business Insider, The New York Times, and The Times of India. Yeah, The Times of India is also pretty decent.
Okay, well, Hima Shankar asks, I have only 30 days more and I am poor at verbal. How to overcome that?
You have only 30 days more and you're poor in verbal. Focus on as many words as you can. That's what I can say.
Okay.
Focus on getting, going through as many words as you can.
Okay. Well, Rishikesh here asks, how many hours did you study every day? As in, how many hours do you prepare for your GRE exam?
3 hours per day consistently without any break.
Okay, well, Shashank Reddy asks, how to approach or write in paragraphs for an issue and an argument.
To be Shashank, to be honest, I'm not in touch with the issue and argument, so if I say something right now, it will be misguiding you. But yes, I can go back and you can take my email ID. I can write back to you, okay?
Okay.
So you can mail me a question and I can write back to you.
Okay, we shall.
Because if I say something right now, it will be misguiding you.
Absolutely. So we shall be sharing our contact details and Ankit's contact details in the end of this seminar. So you can mail us your questions and we or Ankit shall be more than happy to answer all your questions in case you miss out upon any questions. Okay?
It's a good question, and I'd like to get back to it. So I'll definitely do that.
Okay, so here is a very interesting question being asked by Indupriya. Well, what did you concentrate on 2 to 3 weeks before your examination date?
Full length tests only. Just give as many full length tests as possible.
Okay. Well, Abhishek here asks, is learning more words sufficient for a decent verbal score?
I'm sorry, no. You have to learn the words in the context in which they are being used, not merely mug them up. And you cannot say that I have learned 5,000 words, so I'll definitely get more than 155 in GRE or 160 in GRE. You need to actually, even if you have a knowledge of 2,000 words and you can apply that knowledge correctly, that is important. You need to learn the words as well as practice them. So just learning words, my friend, it's not sufficient.
Well, Kariba Sappa here asks, I studied 1000 words and completed all topics in maths and got 308, 159 quants, 149 verbal. So I'm in dilemma to write GRE again or not, because I'm a working professional and will get less time, but not sure how good is this score. What would you suggest? So could you please answer this question?
If you are aiming for spring 2015, I think you have less time on your hands. But if you're going for fall, you still have some time on your hands. And if you think you can improve, then why not? Go for it.
Okay, well, Debajyoti here asks, how much of a flowery language is required in AWA?
Please don't use flowery language. Please write to the point. Flowery
Absolutely.
language, and he will not score well.
Absolutely. Well, this is something that you guys need to be very particular about. Everything that you write has to be context based, and your content is really, really important.
Yes.
Okay, so yeah,
Yes.
well, Krishna here asks, what was your score in ETS tests?
320. I gave two tests and I scored 320 in both.
Okay, well, that's a good score. Well, Rishikesh here
Here
asks,
I'd like
yeah, please continue.
here I'd like to add, sorry Ruchiraj, that ETS tests are the most accurate, and you need to give those two tests in the last 2 weeks. Okay, and those scores will actually reflect your real scores. So give those tests very, very seriously. Yeah, you can go on to the next question.
Yes, well, Rushikesh here asks, what is meant by practicing words?
Practicing words, my friend, means you practice the reading comprehension, you practice the questions basically which are in the modules and the questions which are there in the ETS guide. You basically are, I'm forgetting the text completion, was it? Ruchira, is it text completion, I think, right?
Yes.
Text completion, basically you need to practice questions. So you need to make, basically if a word is given to you, you should know that what if you don't know its exact meaning, that you should be knowing its approximate meaning, like what it is leaning towards. Is it a positive sounding word? Is it a negative sounding word? Or does it imply a good thing? Does it imply a bad thing? Basically, that is called having a good vocabulary.
Okay, well, thanks for that answer. Well, Komal here asks, I'm a working graduate. I'll be having around 3 hour time maximum to spend to study. Please suggest the best way for preparations, considering that I haven't started any preparations at all. I must take GRE and IELTS and a few more language exams. Please suggest me the best plan for the preparations.
Komal, I'd like you to suggest to take up the complete GRE package of GRE.com. And I think if you're sufficiently confident in your quants, sorry, in your verbal, then 3 months is more than sufficient. And let me tell you that lots of my friends were working and they gave GRE along with it, and it did not affect their scores. So you can do it as well.
Okay, well, Saurabh here asks, how did you use the word which you learnt for, as in terms of preparation? How exactly did you use the words?
By writing in the essays, like as I said, that when I was writing in my essays to the SFAs, I used to not consciously use them, but I used to use them in the context which were there in which they were most suitable. So if you write for your issue and your argument essays, you'll automatically be applying your learned words into the essays.
Okay, well, moving on, we shall be taking up the rest of the questions of yours guys in the Q&A session, and so right now I'd request you to kindly be patient for a couple of more minutes. We are approaching the end of the seminar, and soon after that we shall be having the Q&A session in which we shall be elaborately answering all your questions related to your admission processes, because a lot of questions are being asked related to the universities, related to different branches, and a lot of questions are being asked related
Yes.
to a diverse set of things. So we would be answering all of them. So guys, please be
Yes.
patient for a couple of more minutes, and let's get done with the mode of preparations and the application procedures that Ankit followed, and then we shall be moving on to the Q&A session. Okay, so Ankit, can we proceed?
Yes. Yeah, sure. Please go ahead.
Okay, Ankit, over here, I would like to ask, what was the role of your SFAs in terms of the preparation that you have had?
I'd just like to reiterate my previous points that my SFAs were indispensable to my preparation for GRE. For my AWAs, I used to be in contact with my SFAs, and especially, to be honest, all of us have a habit of procrastination, right? So
Exactly.
we are not all perfect human beings. So we might miss a few lessons in between, and that's where the SFAs come in. And they email you that you have been lagging behind, and they actually tell you where you stand, and that is the most important part. I lag behind sometimes, maybe a week or two, and I used to get an email, I used to get a reminder that you need to complete the following lessons in this amount of time so you can be on track for your GRE. So yes, SFAs were helpful in this case. They were very, very helpful.
Okay. Well, moving on with the seminar right now. Well, this is something that a lot of questions have been put across, and I'm sure, Ankit, we would also like to know from your side. How was the experience on the examination day?
In one word, it is exhausting. I think GRE is a test of your endurance, because you have to sit in front of a computer screen for 4 hours and apply your mind. It was very exhausting, but when I saw my scores at the end of the test, I was pleased. I'd like to recommend here that get a good night's sleep, before the night of the examination, try to relax a little. Try to relax, basically. And as far as my experience is concerned, as I said, I was a little disappointed with my quant scores, but my verbal more than made it up for it.
Okay, over here, I would like to take a poll, Ankit. So guys, please answer this poll for me. Okay. The poll that is there on your screen right now. Well, I would like you guys to answer the poll for me. Okay. Well, meanwhile, I would also like to know from you guys, now that we have come to around an hour of discussion, so I would like to know more about the attendees here, and I'm sure Ankit would also like to know that from which college or what are you doing right now, and if you are a working professional, then where are you working, what are you working, which company are you working for, and if you're a student, then which branch are you in, and which college are you studying in? Well, Komal Teja says he's a working professional. Anurag says he has just completed his graduation.
Okay.
Shrujani is in fourth year. Rupanch is in fourth year of his engineering. Hemant is from NIT Bhopal. Vivek Mishra is from NIT Rourkela.
Okay.
Vipin is from IIT Kanpur doing his in material science. Well, that's interesting.
That's nice.
Nagarjuna is working in L&T. Rohit says he's from Government Engineering College. Okay. Harita is doing a BTech from BIET. Pranti is studying in EC branch. Praveen is a working professional with Reliance Industries.
That's nice. Lots of diversity here.
Yes, a tremendous amount of diversity here. Okay. And Shrey Agarwal here is doing a civil engineering from VIT University.
Okay, that's good.
Okay, a lot of diversity here, Ankit, and I'm sure there are a lot of people here would be asking a diverse set of questions, so I'm expecting you to be prepared to answer all the questions.
Yeah, sure.
Okay, with this, I close the poll. Okay, now let's move on. Okay. Okay, Ankit, so can we move on with our presentation?
Yes, yes, let's move ahead to the next part.
Okay, now coming down to yet another very, very important part of the entire circumstance of your GRE and your application processes. Well, this is the part where we discuss about the application procedure which is involved. Okay, so we would like to know, Ankit, as to what exactly was your strategy as far as the application procedures were concerned. Now that we know that you gave your GRE exam in the month of?
August.
August. well, your GRE score was 321, and you had a phenomenally good GRE score with your with a and a reasonably good AWS score as well. Now, after that, what was the strategy that you adopted as far as the application procedure is concerned?
You need to be very proactive, as in you need to get all your statement of purposes, letter of recommendations, ready by the end of September or October. You should not be in a rush to meet the deadlines, because if you are, you'll flounder in some way or the other. So my strategy was, as soon as I was done with my GRE, I started working on my statement of purpose. The very next day, I didn't let up for a while. I did had a little slack time, but I was on my statement of purpose. So I'd like to suggest that you need to prepare all your materials at least by the end of September or beginning of October, so that you can meet all the deadlines by November beginning or December. So I think, Ruchira, that's my point. You need to get all your materials in order by September end.
Okay, well, how many universities did you apply to, Ankit? And what was your strategy as far as shortlisting of universities is concerned?
The first criteria is obviously the rankings, but it should not be the last criteria. The first criteria was ranking, and the second criteria was research. So I chose 10 universities, and basically three were ambitious, three were moderate, and four were safe. So I think you should break it down like this. If you apply to 9 universities, three should be very ambitious. Not very, but ambitious for you. Three should be like, okay, I can get into this. And next three, like, I will definitely get into this. So this is the funda of shortlisting universities.
Okay, now as far as your SOP and your letter of recommendations are concerned, what exactly did you do for drafting your SOP?
For my SOP, basically, I conveyed my whole life story in 2 pages, and I got it proof-checked by as many people as possible. The most important part about the SOP is that you need to get it proof-checked by people who do not know you well, right? So you can get an idea of how you are projecting yourself to the world, because the admissions officer sitting in a US university won't know you personally, right? So you need to show your statement of purpose to as many as people as possible who do not know you well. I got it proof checked from around 10 to 15 people, and I did not finalize it till I was absolutely sure that this was my SOP, because SOP is the one part of application process which you completely control.
Hello.
But SOPs you have complete control over. Hello?
Yes, Ankit, please continue.
SOPs you have complete control over. So I'd like to suggest all the students that draft an SOP, draft an initial SOP, and get it proof checked by as many people as possible. Yes, and if you want a sample of my SOPs, I can send it to you guys. So let me know if you want it.
Absolutely. So we shall be sharing Ankit's mail ID and our contact details with you guys by the end of this seminar. Okay. So you can post questions and any relevant information that you feel is necessary for your preparation for GRE and for the application procedures. Kindly mail it to us and we shall revert. Okay. So with this, we would also like to know, Ankit, now that we have discussed about the SOP, now what about LORs? What is the significance of an LOR in the application process?
LOI is a very highly significant component, because a glowing letter of recommendation from a professor of a reputed university matters more than your maybe your CGPA even sometimes. Because even if you have done a good research work in some good university and the professor recommends you very highly, then it counts very, 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 very. It's very important, you can say. After GRE, I think LORs and SOP combined are the most important part.
Okay, well, that's good. So, Ankit, over here, I would like to ask you, now, what are the things that are necessary to be put in an academic profile, and when should a student essentially start sending the universities their applications?
you should start sending the applications by October. Here I'd like to add that I received my first admit from Purdue University in October itself, because Purdue University has a rolling deadline. By rolling deadline, I mean that as soon as you give your application, you can have the results in within 1 or 2 months' time. So for people who are a little conscious about how their profile is, they can actually apply to 1 or 2 universities who have rolling deadlines and see whether they get admitted or rejected. So by September, I think you should start applying. And that's it. Yeah. September and October.
Okay. Well, this is in terms of your fall admission, right?
Yes, this is for fall. Yes.
Well, over here, I would like to inform, as in say something to all the students who are attending the seminar, that if you are planning, so basically, I'm sure that you guys would be aware that there are two admission seasons. That is, one is fall and the other is spring. So if you are planning to get into the fall season, then you should probably give your GRE exam anytime before October, because all the major deadlines, all the universities, the good universities have the deadlines scheduled starting from the month of October, because this is inclusive of the scholarship deadlines as well. So please make sure that if you're planning to go for the admit season admit season of fall, then please make sure that you're done with your GRE by October, so that you can apply to as many universities as you want, and you would have a good amount of time in order to apply to multiple universities, isn't it, Ankit?
Yes, and one more point I'd like to add here is that people should not shy away from applying to a large number of universities. Sometimes people will say that, oh, it costs a lot, you are spending so much money in applying, and you should never convert the dollars into rupees, and you should never money should not be a factor while choosing the universities, because once you go for MS, you'll be paying around $20,000 to $25,000 per annum for your tuition fee, and if you are just shying away for $60 for an application fee. So I'm trying to bring it in context here that you should apply to as many universities as possible without feeling that money is a constraint. It is expensive, no doubt it is, but it should not be a constraint.
Absolutely. Well, over here, I would like to bring into context the spring admissions. Now, as far as spring admissions are concerned, their classes usually start in the month of January. Okay.
January.
So, as far as spring admissions are concerned, students should usually get done with their GRE examinations before the month of June, or before the month of June, so that they have a good amount of time in order to apply to the universities. And it is also a fact that the amount of competition for the spring season is reasonably less. However, the number of seats is also less. Okay, so are there anything, any inputs from your side as far as the spring season is concerned?
See, if you're working professional, I think only working professionals are the people who can go for spring season. And they should not feel that spring has an advantage or fall has a disadvantage. It's not like that. Everything evens out in the end. So if you want to apply for spring, as Ruchiraj said, get all your scores in order by June or July. And because I think August is the deadline in most cases for spring, August or September.
Absolutely. Well, let's move on with the discussion. So, Ankit, now what about the visa application processes?
To be honest, visa is the most hyped process. You just need to go out there and speak the truth. If you are a genuine student, they will never deny your visa. 99.99% of the time, students get visa. So, don't worry about it.
Absolutely. Well, Ankit, I'm sure a lot of questions. Yes.
Here I'd like to add a point that, yes, if you are from a technology alert list, it's called TAL. You should look it up on Google, that your subject is not under technology alert list. It consists of subjects like pharmaceutical industry, biotechnology, I think, and nuclear research. So these are areas they are very conscious about. So there might be a delay in processing the visa. It is called 2 to 1G. But it is very rare, so you should look it up, and just for the knowledge sake, okay?
Okay. Well, Ankit, I'm sure a lot of questions are pending here, and I think we should start with answering a couple of questions here before we move on with the discussion. What do you say?
Yes,
Okay.
let's do it.
So, again, we'll start with Gulnaz here. So here Gulnaz asks, is it fine if I apply to university now for my spring admission and send my GRE scores later after the deadline?
You have to check with the university because I'm not the authority here. You have to check with the university. Ask the admission process. Ask the admission guys. They have a specific contact ID on the website. Ask them.
Exactly. So the point being, you will have to go to the university websites and check what are the deadlines as far as the applications are concerned. Okay. Well,
Yes, you need to be in contact with them.
okay. Well, again, now Hemant here asks, I have two papers in an international conference, but in transportation. Okay, I'm interested
Okay.
in materials, concrete technology. Is it helpful and can I mention it in my SOP?
Of course it is helpful because it shows that you have the potential of doing research. So, of course, put it in. It will count in because even I know it's not relevant, but it shows that you have the potential to do research. So, I'd suggest you put it in.
Okay. Well, Pranit here asks, are most of the Indian students able to earn a job after getting done with their masters?
See, this is a very subjective question. It depends on the university which you're doing it from, because getting a job there is solely dependent on your abilities. It's not like campus placement where companies will come and hire you. You have to search a job on your own. So, if you're having a good background and if you have a good CGPA in your masters as well, generally people do get jobs. There are very less fraction of students who are not able to land jobs. But again, it solely depends on your own ability.
Okay, well, Gautam Reddy here asks, I'm a working professional, so is it compulsory that I have to submit an LOR from work?
No. You can get it all submitted from the professors from your universities.
Okay, well, Shikha Gupta here asks, well, would like Ankit's advice on this as well. I'm unable to identify my area of interest. Could you please suggest me how can I choose my specialization if I want to pursue MS in computer science in the United States? Did you recommend me to switch multiple jobs so that I can get a taste of different areas in the software industry?
At this stage, I think this is a very computer-specific question, but I'd like to make some sensible point. I'd like to say that if you do not have a sense
Yes, Ankit, please continue. Hello? Hello, Ankit? Hello? Hello, Ankit, can you hear me?
Hello,
Yes.
am I audible?
Yes, Ankit. Please continue.
Yeah, I can. Am I audible?
Yes.
As I was saying that if you don't have a idea by now that what area of interest, what is your area of interest, then you have no other option but to try different jobs. That's it.
Okay. Okay, well, Sandesh here asks, I don't have a good CGPA, but I have 1 month left. Okay. Well, I have 1 month of internship experience from Atlas Copco, and I'm currently working with Volkswagen. on a project, if I got a good GRE score, do I stand a chance of applying to good universities?
Okay. Yes, you have. See, CGPA is a major factor, but it is not the deciding factor. If you have good internships, if you have good letter of recommendations, it will come into play. So don't worry about a low CGPA. What is done is done. You don't have any control about your past, so just focus on
Hello, Ankit. Hello.
Yeah, I'm here.
Yes. Okay.
Yeah, hello?
I believe there's some technical glitch here, guys. I'm really sorry.
Hello. Am I audible?
Yes. Yes, Ankit, you're audible. Could you please repeat?
I was saying that a low CGPA is. You don't have any control over it. You can't go back into your past and improve the CGPA. So get as many internships as possible, get as much relevant work experience as possible, and you'll stand a good chance.
Okay. Well, Apurva here asks, for how long the process of making applications last, like LORs, SOPs, and the application process? So basically, what is the total duration as far as the documentation processes are concerned and the application of application to the multiple universities is concerned?
I think you can get it done in 1 to 1.5 months.
Okay, so according to you, an ideal time would be 1.5 to 2 months.
Yes, 1.5 to 2 months.
Okay. Well, over here, I would like to take up a couple of more questions. Shikha here asks, do you recommend me to take a variety of online video courses on EDX or Coursera to choose which specialization to take up? So Shikha here basically would want to know that would the online courses be of any help?
It depends on whether she's an undergraduate or whether she's working. Can we have that detail?
Yes. So Shikha, we would like to know whether you are an undergraduate or you are a working professional. Well, Shikha says she's working at Adobe.
She's working at Adobe.
Yes.
So, as far as freelance softwares are concerned, I think if you have a particular interest and you want to pursue it, they are most welcome. You should go for it. I'd rather encourage them. I myself was.
Hello. Hello.
Yeah.
Yes, Ankit, I believe there's some technical glitch from your side.
Hello.
Yes. Guys, can you hear us?
I hope it's clear now.
Yes, it's clear to me. I don't know about the students who are attending the seminar. Guys, are we clear? Is my voice and Ankit's voice clear to you guys? Okay, that's brilliant. Well, Ankit, yes. So, would you like to please repeat?
Okay. Question which was regarding the open courseware. Yes, I'd like to encourage students. I myself used to watch NPTEL videos and other free softwares, free coursewares. So yes, if you want to pursue a subject and gain more knowledge about it, you should go for them.
Okay, that's great. Okay, now we would like to take another question. Yes, Sohini asks, when should I give my TOEFL if I'm giving my GRE on 2nd of August?
Two weeks after that.
Well, in 2 weeks. Okay, that's great. Okay, so
yeah.
Well, Now, Sri Lakshmi here asks, can GRE score be sent to universities without taking IELTS or TOEFL?
Yeah, it is independent. GRE is completely independent.
Okay, well, right now we guys will be proceeding with the seminar, and we are almost done with the seminar, and we are proceeding to the Q&A session right now. So, couple of more minutes, and then we shall be starting with the Q&A session. So, kindly be patient. We'll be answering all your questions, and let's proceed. So, Ankit, what is it that you would like to recommend to all your fellow MS aspirants?
I'd like to recommend the fact that give your GRE in time, give your TOEFL in time, most preferably by August if you're targeting fall. Don't worry about a negative part of the application if you have one. If you have a low CGPA, don't worry about it. If you don't have work, if you don't have paper publications, don't worry about it. Try to improve those aspects of the applications which you have control over, right? And also, like I said earlier, you need to identify your weak areas in the beginning and focus on improving them. Give the diagnostic test and focus on improving the weak areas. Especially at the end of the day, GRE is not a matter of life and death. If you get a score less than maybe what you targeted, maybe if you targeted 320 and you got 315, so you should not worry about it. You can always make up for it. That is the beauty of the admission process. So yeah, that is my tips and tricks in a nutshell.
Okay. Well, guys, after that, I would also like to ask Ankit, how was his experience with GRE yet? So, Ankit, would you like to please share your experience with us in terms of your experience you have had with GRE Edge in the preparation for your GRE?
I was fully satisfied. The most important part is that all the material is consolidated in a single place. You have access to it at one place. The second part, you don't have to rush to a coaching class. You don't have to physically attend a coaching class. You can do it in the comfort of your home, in the comfort of your office, wherever. And you have control over it. There's no specific time. So with this mobility, basically, I loved about GREEdge.com and the availability of sufficient practice.
We shall be starting with the Q&A session that you guys have been eagerly waiting for. So, Ankit, are you ready?
Yes, let's go ahead.
Okay. So, well, Hemant here asks, I am planning to do my major project in a premier institute, but in January. So, when should I apply for fall 2016 or later?
If you are starting the project in January, so I think you should apply for later because it will not be reflected in your application. So yes, you should apply later.
Okay. Now, Dushyant here asks, which universities would you recommend for structural engineering?
I'd like to recommend, basically it depends on your profile really, but few standard ones which are very good are like which from where I got admit from is UCLA is pretty good. UCSD, University of California at San Diego, is pretty good. North Carolina State University is pretty good. It's my university, so it has to be good. Stanford and Cornell, they are pretty ambitious, but yes, they are very good. You can have a look on the website usnews.com, and they have a pretty comprehensive list according to the specializations, so you'll get a better list there. But these are the universities I told you in brief.
Okay, well, we have a question on our Facebook page on the post that we have made on the Facebook page. That is, what were the mistakes that you made in your exam, and how can we overcome those mistakes?
I made silly mistakes in quant. I think that I didn't practice enough questions of probability. The standard which I was expecting in real GRE was a little tougher than what I was expecting. So I think my mistake was not practicing well enough for quants.
Okay, well, There is another question being posted by Sumant here. I have 72% in civil engineering, while the topper's percentage in my class is 76. So, one second. Well, my topper's percentage is 76. I scored 300, verbal 146, quants 154, IELTS 7, one national level publication, and two normal internships, and a lot of extracurricular and social activities. Do I have a chance for funding? Suggest me some good universities for my score.
I think I'd like to answer you personally. You can send it on my personal email ID. Like, I can suggest you universities because if it's not in my head right now, but I can do a personal search and suggest you good universities for your profile.
Okay, here I would request you, Ankit, to kindly share your email ID with us so that we can forward it to everybody.
I'm typing
Okay.
it down. I hope everyone can see it now. Can everyone see it?
Yes, I shall be sharing it with all of them. I have received the mail ID. I shall be sharing with all you guys in a while. Okay.
Okay.
Okay. So here Arya Bharadwaj asks, what are the main areas that mainly enhance your GRE score? This is a question that has been posted on the Facebook page.
Main areas which enhance your GRE score. I think the reading comprehension part, because everyone is sort of equally good in quants and the words, but the reading comprehension part is where you are separated from the crowd.
Okay. Well, Saroj here asks, do we have to produce a work experience certificate along with LORs and SOPs while applying for the universities?
No, you don't have to produce a work experience certificate, but I suggest that you don't make use of this fact and lie about your profile. Please don't lie about your profile.
Okay. Well, Lopamudra Pal here asks, how did Ankit get full funding? This is a very interesting question.
How?
Ankit, please answer.
My profile was basically a very relevant to the research group I'm going in. I contacted the professor there in the month of October, and I was lucky that I was in the right place at the right time with the right profile. So basically, luck is when preparation meets opportunity, right? So if you're prepared and you send your resume to the right people, you'll have a good chance. So if you want a good chance of funding, I suggest that you write to professors beforehand. Don't junk email. Write very specifically that what are your attributes, how can you contribute to their research group, and how is your profile relevant to what will you be doing in your master's. Then you will have a good chance of getting a scholarship.
Okay, well, there is yet another interesting question that has been posted by Divakar on our Facebook page, that if one doesn't have papers and patents, can he still make it to the Ivy League universities? If so, what would be the other
Yeah,
criteria required?
yes. It is a myth that you need paper publications to get into Ivy Leagues. I've seen lots of my friends get into Ivy Leagues without paper publications. To compensate the absence of paper publications, you need to have good internships, good CGPA, good letter of recommendations, and good SOPs.
Okay. Well, Arshdeep here asks, I'm in third year of electronics and telecommunications. Can you help me with pointers as to what I should do to build into a great profile? So, what are the things that are required to build a great profile and an academic profile per se?
If you are looking for a very good academic profile, I suggest that you get an internship in a good place and you actually learn something from that internship. Many people get internships but merely for the certificates. I highly suggest that you get into a very good internship program and learn from it so that it may be added as a skill in your resume.
Okay, well that's good. Now Nagarjuna here asks for your mail ID. Nagarjuna, we shall be sharing your mail, sharing Ankit's mail ID with you guys in a while. Manogyan here asks, what stands more important for getting funding? What are the criteria that are necessary for getting a funding?
your research, your personal research, because there are universities which are ranked 60th or 70th, but they have extensive research going on. So it here your hard work comes in. You need to go to the respective websites. You need to look out that which professors have funding. You need to see what are the amount of research grants available and then apply accordingly. So even if you have a moderate profile, but you have done a very strong homework, you can get funding. It's not impossible.
Okay, well, I believe that Manogyan has received the answer. Well, I shall be taking up a couple of good questions here. Now, well, Rupanch asks, I am planning for MS in fall 2016. If I do research internship in my eighth sem, that is April 2016, will that add to my profile while getting an admit?
I'm sorry, because you will have applied by December 2015, so you'll not be able to add that into your profile.
Okay.
But you can always write in your SOP that you will do a project in June, sorry, in April. So you can mention that in your SOP.
Okay. Well, Mudita asks here, and I would like to answer her question. When to apply for funds? Well, Mudita, there are multiple funding types. So, and the deadlines for the fundings that are that students usually look forward to are different. So over here, I would recommend you to go to the university websites and check the types of funding that they provide to the students and accordingly apply to them as per the deadlines that has been scheduled by the university. So first, go to the university website, check what are the funding options available with that university, and then check the deadlines for those funding options and how essentially can an individual apply. Okay, well, moving on. Well, Sai Kumar here asks, would you suggest to have a work experience before your master's, or do you suggest to take up master's directly? Ankit, what are your views on this?
I personally suggest that you should take some work experience. It helps a lot. You get to have a broader perspective, because once you are going into the master's directly, it's like transferring from an academic environment to again an academic environment. So if you can get into a good company, then why not go for the work experience?
Absolutely. Well, that's a good answer. Over here, there is yet a very interesting question that has been put up by Teja Kominani on our Facebook page. How did you know about the structural engineering research that is going on in NCSU? Well, he says, I'm a CSE student and very much interested in topics of operating systems and computer networks, but don't have any research experience. Can I get a PhD? If so, what are the attributes that I should have? Well, there are two parts to the question, Ankit. So first, how did you get to know about the research activities that are going on? And second, what essentially should the student do in order to build up the attributes that are necessary to get a PhD?
Okay, the first part is regarding the research.
Yes.
Everything is available on the university website, but you need to be thorough, because they will have research expenditures as well by the year, by the professor. So if you do your homework properly, the research expenditures by the research expenditures you can figure out that what is the amount of work that is being carried out, because ultimately a part of the research expenditure is your scholarship, right? So
Exactly.
you need to see what are the research expenditures of the university. Secondly, if you don't have any papers or publications, don't worry about it. Work towards building them. I have reiterated this point again and again. You should be relevant to the university. Bag a suitable internship, do a suitable part-time job, or take a suitable work experience which is relevant to the profile. And don't worry, if there's a university which doesn't have a profile which suits you, there are 50 or 100 more universities. You can look at them and see which suits you.
Okay, well, thank you for the answer, Ankit. Well, moving on with the next question. Well, Satya Narayana here asks, will our BTech college affect our master's college admissions?
To be honest, they do affect it. they do affect, but you should not get discouraged, because I've seen people from not so good colleges get in because they had very good GRE scores, very good internships. Yes, if you are from an IIT or an NIT, you will get a head start, but that does not mean that the brand matters only. You can get into a good college on the basis of your GRE scores and a relevant profile.
Absolutely. Well, Ankit, I would like to take a few seconds to answer a couple of questions here regarding a lot of questions are being posted by various students related to other branches. I would like to answer them with your permission, of course. Well, Pulivarti Srija asked, best universities for CSE students. Well, Srija, the good universities for any universities have to be identified based on the regions that the universities are located in. Well, as far as CSE is concerned, or computers or information technology is concerned, the California region is really good. So you should probably target the universities which are based in those in California, because the internship opportunities, the research opportunities, and the job prospects as far as if you are a student in those universities increases reasonably in comparison to the other universities. Well, I am not saying that you would not get placed if you are studying in a good college which is not in these regions. However, the chances of getting the placements and opportunities increases comprehensively.
Exactly. The probability increases. Yes,
exactly.
Probability increases.
Now, as far as robotics and mechanical engineering is concerned, well, for robotics, Georgia Tech is a very good university. So, guys who are looking forward to doing Georgia Tech might consider applying to Georgia Tech. Well, as far as your mechanical engineering is concerned, well, mechanical engineering, the University of Michigan Ann Arbor is the most sought after university, because a lot of industries and a lot of companies are situated in the Michigan region. So guys, if you are looking forward to applying into universities, and if you are from a mechanical background, so kindly consider applying into universities that are located in the area of Michigan. Now, as far as biosciences are concerned, universities such as John Hopkins are really good, which are the most reputed universities in the biosciences field. So if you're a biosciences student, kindly apply to John Hopkins, and of course your Georgia Tech and MIT, Stanford, these universities are really good universities. So if you're looking forward to application procedures, then kindly look forward to these universities. Well, moving back to, again, Ankit. Now, Sai Kumar here asks, you suggested me to have experience before my master's. So my question is, should I start working in research institute or in some industry? Well, this is a very relevant question.
See, if you want to go for a master's, an academic internship is always preferred. This is a very, very specific question, because sometimes in industries also relevant academic work is being carried out. So, but if you want to answer as a generic answer, academic internship is always preferred.
Okay. Well, thank you for the answer. Okay. Well, Sumant here says we have Ankit's birthday in next 4 days, so we should wish him a very happy birthday. So, Ankit, we would like to wish you a very, very happy birthday. And can we have a huge round of applause as a birthday wish to Ankit in advance? Well, a lot of students
thanks,
are wishing
guys,
here. Teja, Sri Lakshmi, Vineet, Jayan Kant, Sagar, Arshdeep, Manyogna, everybody is wishing you a very, very happy birthday in advance. Okay.
Thanks, guys.
Ankit, would you
thanks
like to say something to them?
I'm very, very humbled by your wishes, and thanks a lot. They really mean a lot to me.
Okay. Well, Srija here asks, I'll do my internship in December. Before that, I would be applying to the universities. Will that be helpful?
Like I said before, your application part is mostly over by December or January. See, if your university has a deadline in February, then your internship experience can be helpful. So you need to go to the university website and see that what is the deadline. If it is coming before that, then I'm afraid it will not be helpful. But if it's coming after that, of course it will be helpful.
Well, thanks a lot for your answer, Ankit. A couple of more birthday wishes have come up here. Okay. Well, guys. Okay, so Srija, Gopika, Venu, they all are wishing you a very happy birthday. Well, guys, so as far as Ankit is concerned, we shall be forwarding his mail ID, and I see a lot of questions are being answered on the Facebook as well. Well, guys, what you can do is, again, instead of spamming Ankit's email ID, what you could probably do is post your questions on your on our Facebook page, and we shall be tagging Ankit over there, and from there, Ankit shall be answering all your questions personally. Okay?
Yes, I'll be more than happy to answer that.
Okay. So, in case you have any of your questions, then we shall be answering all of them. In case you feel that we have left out any of your question, then we would be answering them over the Facebook. Okay, we shall be tagging Ankit, and we shall and we'll make either we or Ankit answers the questions.
No problems.
And you can also send him a friend request, and you can wish him on his birthday as well. So that is also a sellout for you guys, and you can personally interact about the experience he's having while he's pursuing his master's and his PhD. So a lot of benefits are there on Facebook. So if you guys are not on
Yes.
Facebook, then I would strongly recommend you. Okay?
Sure, guys. I'd look forward to interacting with you all.
Okay. Well, a lot of students over here are looking forward to your SOP, so we shall be sending you guys his SOP as well. Now, after that, yeah. Now there is yet another question that has been asked. Is it suggested to do internship after I finish my graduation? Because I want to enhance my knowledge on the domain after working for around 10 months in an uninteresting field. And if yes, please suggest me the source to find.
If you are suggesting for IITs, there's a link called IRCC of IIT Bombay. IIT Bombay. It is called Industrial Research and Consultancy Center. So you should go there and look it up. Go on the respective academic institutions and look for the internship opportunities. That much I can suggest to you.
Okay, so I believe a lot of questions are coming up, and the transition has happened from the chat box to the Facebook group, Facebook page. So we shall be closing this seminar now, but before that, we would like to share our contact details with you guys. So in case you guys have any doubts that has been left unanswered, you can mail it to us on this website, on this on the mail ID that has been shared. Or you can make a po you can post a comment on our Facebook page. A guest seminar post has been made on our Facebook page. You can post your questions there, or you can mail it to us, or you can ask Ankit over the Facebook page right away, because we would really not want you to want you guys to spam Ankit's profile with your questions, too many questions, and I'm sure Ankit would also not like that. So if you want all your questions to be answered, then kindly post your question as a comment on the Facebook post that has been made on our page, or you can mail it to us at info@grehedge.com. Okay, with this, we come to the end of this seminar. I hope you guys enjoyed the seminar, and if there are any questions
Yeah.
that we could not answer, we are extremely sorry. Because of time constraints, we are not unable to answer them. And Ankit, I would personally like to thank you for coming to give this online seminar and spending 2.5 hours with us. It has been very, very enlightening experience for us, and I'm sure you also enjoyed this seminar, interacting with a lot of students. And yes, that's pretty much about it. Ankit, your last words.
Yeah, thanks a lot. I hope that you found it helpful. I hope it was not boring. So if it was helpful and even if it motivates a few guys to, go for it, I'll be happy. So thanks a lot.
Absolutely. Well, so guys, with this, we come to the end of the seminar. Okay, so if in case you guys have any doubts, then kindly mail it to us at info@grehedge.com. Okay, and we shall be answering all of them. And Abhishek wishes you happy birthday in advance.
Thank
Well,
you. Thanks a lot.
yes, and with this, we come to the end of today's online seminar. Okay, thank you for attending the seminar. All the best, have a good night, and happy learning with GRE Edge.
Thank you, guys. Bye-bye.